Hey everyone, welcome to Coding Simplified, and now we'll see a new problem in a string. So basically we are given a string and we need to reverse the individual words in that one. So for example, if we have this string where we have coding space simplified space nice, so it should be converted to this one. It means we'll reverse this word, then we'll reverse this word, then we'll reverse this word, and the rest template should be same. Right, it means the words should be at same position, it's just that we are reversing individual words. Right, so this is our question, that we need to reverse individual words. So for that we'll see one by one, we'll see two or three solutions that how we can implement that, then we'll see what will be the time complexity and space complexity, and at the last we'll see that how we can implement through Java code. So let's say if we have this coding, then space, then simplified, then space, right? So it means that till space, if we separate this one, let's say if we have only this string, right? It means what we need to do, we need to reverse this string, right? We need to reverse this portion. So for that, in our last tutorial, we also did that how we can reverse a particular string. So in that, what we do, that at the starting we take a blank string, and then we keep on adding the element at the starting, right? So let's say if we do the same thing here. So let's say if I have a string which is at the starting blank, now I will keep on adding the element at the starting when I'm iterating the string. So it means then I will add the C here, when O will come here, then it will be at the starting, again D came at the starting, when I come, then I is also starting, then N, then G, right? So this is how I reverse a particular string. So it means what I can do, the same thing I can do, that I will iterate the loop from I equal to 0, means 0th index, to N minus 1st index, which is the last index of the string. Now if it is not a space, though I will keep on adding the element at the starting, right? So for that I will take a temporary string or I will take a final string. So if it is not a space, I will keep on adding the element at the starting. So that's what I'm doing, string dot char at I, right? So my str is a string, the given string, and using char at I can get the character at that particular index. So it's a Java function. In each language it has its own function. So either what you can do, you can completely convert into a character array. So then you can simply fetch the element, the character array and ith index. Right, but here we are just getting the character using this caret function. So using str.caret i, you can get the character at a particular element, and then plus temporary string. So basically this is how we are adding the element at the starting, right? So this is when we need to do a particular, when to reverse do a particular words. Now whenever there is a space, then we need to maintain a final string as well. So for that what we are doing, we are taking a final string, and whenever there is a space, I'm adding this temporary string into final string. So whenever there is a space, it means, so this is what you are doing when it is not a space, but when it is a space, so add this temporary string into final string, right? And then we need to add the space as well. So this, and then we are adding the space as well. So what will happen? That when it will getting the space, so this will add the final string. At the starting, final string is blank, so it means final string plus the stamp string, and then add the space as well, right? And then at the same time we are also setting this temporary string to blank, so that we can execute the same thing for next word as well, right? So when simplified will be there, again it will do the same thing, because at the starting temporary string is blank, so it will keep on adding the element at the starting. So it will add S, then it will add I, then M, then P, then L, then I, then F, then I, then E, and then D, right? And then it has the space. So when it is a space, this was our final string, so it will add this string into this final string. So this will add at the starting, and then we'll add the space as well. Now we'll set this temporary string to the blank again, when then we'll have the nice. So it will do the same thing, that it will add N, then I, then C, then E, right? And when we'll reach at last index, so at that point it will just keep it as it is. So now we haven't added this one to the last one, the last final string. So for that, at after the for loop, because our for loop exists from here to here, then after that the same thing we need to do for once last as well. So then we are adding final string equal to final string plus temporary string, right? So when we will do that, then it will add this string to at the last as well, like at this position, right? So this is how we are solving our question. This is how we are reversing individual word. So to reverse individual word, we are basically doing the same thing where we reverse a string. That we are keep on adding the element at the, we are keep on adding the character at the starting, and at the last we'll have the reverse word. And then to maintain the complete string, we are taking a final string, and then we are keep on adding the words in that final string, right? So this is how we'll solve this question. Now if you talk about the time complexity and space complexity, so basically if there are n characters, so we are iterating from total n characters, right? It means my time complexity will be big of n. Now if you talk about the space complexity, so basically we are using two strings, so this is a constant, so I can say this is big of one, right? But here is little bit catch, because what we are doing that basically you are taking a string, right? And whenever we are keep on adding the element, so like when we added C, then O, so because as you know that in Java, string is an immutable object. Immutable object means whenever you are adding any element, it is basically creating a new string in the string pool, right? So this is, so whenever we are creating anything or whenever you are updating any string, you are basically keep on creating the strings, right? It means we are creating so many strings when we are solving our question, right? So this is little bit problem, or you can say this is, so here we can improve little bit. So what we can do, so here is our second solution, that rather than a string, we can take a string builder, right? And using string builder function, we can execute this. So then it will not create again and again new strings. It will do in the same string one, right? So let me show you what I mean. So first of all, let me show you the first solution. Right. So this is what you are doing. We were passing the string. Then at the starting, we took two strings, final string and temporary string. Both are blank. Now I'm iterating from I equal to 0 to the last index, and I'm getting the character at that particular index. Now if character is space, so I'm adding in the final string, right? So add this temporary string to final string, and then add space as well, and then set temporary string to blank. But if it is not the case, so I'm adding the character at the starting, right? And then I added the at the last final string equal to final string plus temporary string, and at the last I can return the final string, right? So this was the thing when I did using string, that reverse individual words. But now let's say if I use using string builder, so if I using string builder, I can improve that one, right? So what will happen, that I will create a string builder rather than a string. Now in string builder, we have an append function, because in a string we add simply like adding plus, but using string builder we have the append. So rather than plus, we have this append temporary string, then append space. Similarly, when we are inserting the element at here at the starting, so to insert the character at the starting, we have this function insert using string builder. So we are saying that temporary string dot insert at the 0th index for this character. So we insert this character at 0th index in string builder, right? So and guys, you can also use string buffer as well. So the only difference is string buffer is thread safe and string builder is not thread safe, right? So it's upon you that what's your requirement. You can use string buffer or string builder. Then what we do, because this is our string builder, so I need to convert into string as well. So this is how I am converting, that convert this into a string, and then at the last it will send. So this was the solution when we did it using iterating the array. Now we can solve this question using another method as well, which is using stack. So in stack, what we do, that until we are not hitting the space, keep on adding the element into stack. So like if we start from here, it will keep on adding the element here C, O, D, I, and G. and whenever we hit space, we basically keep on popping the element till the last element and then we print it. So like here G N I D O C and then we add the space. So now my stack will be empty. Now I do the same thing for another one as well. So again it will add as I am and then I'll keep on popping out the element, right? So this is the third way so that we can do using stack. Now let me show you the code as well. So like I create the stack which is of character. Now I operate this until n length. I'll get the character and if it is not the space, so I'll pushing the character in the stack. And whenever I hit the space, so until it's not empty, I'll keep on printing the element from the stack. And then at the last, I will print the space as well. And at the last, and this is for the last one, that until it is not empty, just keep on printing the element, right? So what's the difference? It's the same thing that you are doing here, that at the last, we need to print whatever the remaining in the stack, right? And guys, here we are not returning, we are just printing the values. If you want to return, what you can do, that rather than printing, you can basically store that value in an array or in a string builder, and then you can return, right? So in that also our complexity is our time complexity is big of n, but our space complexity increases because we are using stack, right? So that's all about this video guys, and if you have any question then please write in the comment section. I will try to explain that, and I will also put the source code into description, so if you want then you can also get it from there. So thanks guys, and if you have liked the video then please like it and subscribe the channel for more such videos. Thank you.